A person in a rowboat 2 miles from the nearest point on a straight shoreline wishes to reach a house 6 miles farther down the shore. If the person can row at a rate of 3 miles per hour and walk at a rate of 5 miles per hour, find the least amount of time required to reach the house. How far from the house should the person land the rowboat? Alright, so our objective. What's our objective? We want the least amount of time. We're trying to minimize time. Alright, so my objective. I want to minimize the time required. Alright, now, I don't have a time function, but there's two things going on here. The person is rowing and walking. So the total time is equal to the time rowing plus the time walking. So, I mean, there's my objective, but gosh, that's not very useful. I don't know what the time rowing is. I don't know how to express it yet. Time walking, I don't know how to express that. Okay, so let's look at the constraints. Now, the constraints is not exactly clear right now. But let's see what we can do. A diagram. A person in a rowboat. So let's draw. Here's my straight shoreline. Relatively straight shoreline. And I have a rowboat that is 2 miles from shore. And so I'm starting here, I'm 2 miles from shore to begin with. And I need to get 6 miles downshore to the house. So I could row directly to shore, right? This 2 miles to shore, and then walk all the way. I could row directly from the current position all the way to the house. A third option is, let's suppose I land the boat some distance from my perpendicular distance from the shore. Let's call this distance X. So I'm going to land the boat X miles from my perpendicular position from shoreline. So then I really am rowing this distance right here, and then just walking this remaining distance. And this remaining distance is 6 minus X miles. Well, now this distance here, the actual distance that I'm going to row, is then from the Pythagorean theorem, would then be the square root of x squared plus 4. All right, now let's see if we can come up with some expressions for the time rowing. Well, let's see. I know if I'm going at a constant rate of speed, I know that distance is equal to rate times time. So then time is equal to distance divided by the rate. Hey, now I can maybe work with this. Let's think about this. What's the time rowing? Well, that would be the distance rowing divided by the rate while rowing. And the distance while rowing is now, I've expressed that as x, in terms of x, as x, the square root of x squared plus 4. And the rate while rowing is 3 miles per hour. Similarly, the time walking can be thought of as the distance walking divided by the rate while walking. The distance while walking is 6 minus x, and the rate is 5. So now, using all of that, I can take my objective function and replace the time rowing and the time walking with those other expressions. So I can now write the time as a function of x, and it's going to be equal to the time rowing. Let's see, that's the square root of x squared plus 4 over 3, and the time walking is 6 minus x over 5. And now I can use some calculus to analyze this. The first derivative, t prime of x. Oh, and I guess we should think of the domain for this. Let's see, what's the domain? Well, I know x, I know it has to be between 0, right? X could be 0, and the maximum value x could take would be 6, right? Because if x was exactly 6, that's the situation where I'm rowing directly from my initial point directly to the house. So I know x must be between 0 and 6. That's the domain. And I guess it could be equal to. All right, so then t prime of x. Let's see, so this is the same as 1/3. Now that square root of x squared plus 4, that's x squared plus 4 to the 1/2 power. So times 1/2 times x squared plus 4 to the negative half, then times from the chain rule, 2x, plus 6 minus x over 5, that's the same as 1/5, and then the derivative of 6 minus x is just negative 1. So if we clean this up a little bit, let's see, that would give me square root of x squared plus, let's see, the x squared plus 4, the square root of x squared plus 4 would now be in the denominator. The 2 and the 1/2 reduce out, so let's say I'd have an x over 3 root x squared plus 4, and then minus 1/5 is t prime of x. And so let's set this equal to 0. So then that's the same as writing x over 3 root x squared plus 4 is equal to 1/5. Let's use some cross products. 5x is equal to 3 root x squared plus 4. Let's square both sides carefully. So then 25x squared is equal to 9 times x squared plus 4. So 25x squared is 9x squared plus 36. So then 16x squared is 36. X squared is 36 over 16. That's what, 9 over 4. So then x would be the positive square root of 9 over 4, 3 over 2. And again, I'm excluding the negative because of the domain. So it looks like x equals 3 over 2 is a critical number. Let's use the first derivative test here. So testing into the first derivative, 0 and 6. And here's 3 halves, that's 1.5. So let's test, say, let's test 0. Let's see what happens at 0. We'd have 0 minus 1/5, so this would be negative. And how about, a positive number? Let's try, how about 3? Let's test x equals 3. Then I'd have 3 over 3 times the square root of 9 plus 4, 3 times, so 1 over the square root of 13 minus 1/5. We could use a calculator, find out that this is positive. So it is minimized. So that's a good sign. Alright, so what's our conclusions then? Find the least amount of time required to reach the house. So let's calculate t. It's t of 1.5. t of 1.5 would be the square root of 1.5 squared plus 4 over 3 plus 6 minus 1.5 over 5. And if we go through all of the arithmetic, I did that on the side over here, this works out to be 26 over 15 as an exact fraction. And so that's approximately 1.73 hours. So that's the first part. That's the minimum time. How far from the house should the person land the boat? How far from the house? Right, how far from the house? Well, how far from the house? That's this distance right here. And so answering that, we should land 4.5 miles from the house. Six minus 1.5, 4.5 miles.